It's a very exciting time, you see, but it's something that cannot really be denied unless you want to live in a cave and just not worry about anything and live off of air. But even then, even if you're in a cave and you're living off of air, that air still is dependent on the quality of what's happening elsewhere in the world. There's no real way to be physically incarnate at this moment and at the same time not really care. There's no way. I mean, if you do that, that's fine, but that is coming from a place of not really being ready to embrace a larger self, to embrace a larger collective as your own, to embrace civilization as your own. We have become disempowered. We have accepted that disempowerment. And out of that disempowerment, that mass disempowerment, we've all turned to our own little bubbles of reality, okay? And that's what occupies most of us. My daily struggles, my daily processes. I'll get there someday. This is what I want. Why isn't it happening yet? I'll watch another YouTube video. I'll make sure that by next year I have what I want. That's all perfectly fine. My whole point being is that personal empowerment is included in the expansion of your consciousness to embrace a larger entity as your own self. Does that make sense? I'll repeat that. Personal empowerment is included naturally, is naturally induced, is naturally a given. The things that you desire, the life that you desire, is naturally given to you when you allow your consciousness to expand to include a larger entity than your own as your own. And this is what's so crucial about being on this planet at this time. This is what's so crucial. And we have opportunities like never before with the internet, with the connectedness, with the rising need and desire and passion for spiritual awakening and personal empowerment and being of service to others. This really is a very exciting time, and I know that all philosophers of all times have said that, but this really is an exciting time. And so it's time for us all to take our personal empowerment to a next level and to blend it with, to whatever extent you are presently capable of, shepherding consciousness and including a larger body as your own self. And so that's what these meetings are about, and because of the timing of what's happening. And again, those that can tune into the probabilities will notice a lot of what's going on and can even predict some of the things that are about to happen, or at least have an abstract sense of it. And so get excited by these intuitions because they're for real. They're not just figments of your imagination. You are, if you're connected, you are sensing that stuff is about to go down. Things are happening. Obviously, if you are sad, if you are most of the time sad or depressed or not really feeling very good within your own skin. If you don't feel good about yourself, at least half of the time, then there is some personal work to be done to increase that well-being, to sharpen your focus in a good way, to soften your judgment, but to sharpen your focus deliberately in ways that you wish to utilize your consciousness. Without personal empowerment, there's no real way to contribute. So yes, it is true, if you're not happy, you're not helping. Okay, if you cannot help anything or anyone or the collective from a state of unhappiness. From a state of unhappiness and being jaded and being skeptical, there's not much you can do because you're not harnessing the power that you have at your capacity. Were you to open up, were you to believe again, were you to have faith within yourself, to have faith in your higher self, to have faith in the orchestration of what's occurring on planet Earth as we speak, to have faith in the timing of the circumstances as they manifest themselves in your personal life. If you can go back to that state of faith and empowerment, then you're in a position to literally call upon the non-physical powers that are innate to each human being. You can call upon the powers of the universe in a very immediate, direct way, from changing the weather, if that makes sense, to simply letting freedom and abundance and creativity flow through your being so that you can be of support to your own life, your immediate family, and the family that is our civilization. So let's go back. Let's review the basics of personal empowerment, according to me. One thing to understand, sort of a disclaimer, is that these teachings that I teach about empowerment work so much better when you realize that you're not a physical body. That is a profound foundation to realize that you are not the physical body. The physical body is like a finger is to the hand. It's like an extension, it's an expression of your personality. As your mind changes, as your vibration, your frequency, your state of being changes, so does your body. So does your mind. So does the actions that you take in this world. So does your feelings. Everything you see, everything you can perceive, sense, including the body, but including much more, including your circumstances, the opportunities that come your way, the people that you meet, the conversations that you have, the things that you create, every single thing that you can sense with your senses or your mind is like looking in a mirror. It's a reflection of your state of being. Okay, that's basically the number one rule of personal empowerment, is to understand that circumstances, and circumstances include the body. The body is a circumstance. Yes. To understand that circumstances reflect state of being, that circumstances are a mirror that you're looking into. Okay, so if the body feels a certain way, it's a reflection of how you've been thinking, how you've been feeling, what you are believing. If the body feels bad in a sense, then most of the time that's a reflection of you holding on to a belief system that no longer works for you. The body is the most immediate circumstance. It's telling you immediately. It's the first mirror you look at every time you wake up to your life, to your daily life. Immediately, how the body responds, emotionally especially, shows you where your mind has been in the past. Shows you where your thoughts have been in the past. Shows you what your present belief system is that you are ready to let go of. If there is a contraction, it means there is a belief underneath that contraction that your higher self disagrees with. Emotional contraction is nothing other than higher self, your higher self, your wiser part, disagreeing with what you are suggesting is true in your thinking, in your belief system. Does that make sense?